I've had this battery in my G-Booster for quite some time. It hasn't been made specifically for my G-Booster, however, it ended up serving me well. It is now a 52 volts configuration and about 33 to 35 amps hour. I'm going to disassemble the whole pack and then to assemble it again with a 16S configuration. I don't know if anyone has done this before, I don't know if there's any other G-Booster on 60 volts out there, but at least in my country, I know that this will be the highest voltage G-Booster. I know that at this point you're probably writing a comment with the question, why are you still keeping the G-Booster in 2023? And that's a good question. The short answer is, because I can, of course. And the long answer is, I have a long history with this scooter. This is my first dual motor scooter and I got it for cheap. It had about 4 or 5 owners before me and I got to be the one that saved it from the junkyard. That was in a time when I wouldn't have the financial resources to upgrade to a better scooter anyway. So I started fixing this one. At this point I fixed it so well that it became double in size and basically unbreakable. I know every part of it because all the nuts and bolts are tightened by me. I've replaced all the bearings and reinforced every weak point. I've used it on any kind of weather instead of a car. You can see the videos about everything I'm saying now on my channel. I think it is safe to say that this pile of aluminium and electricity is already a part of the family and not only a scooter. Now getting back to the battery, the blue cells are LG, as for the green ones, I'm not sure if they are BAC or just no-name cells. I'm going to reuse all the cells from the pack. They need to be polished first so that the new nickel strip can be welded on each end. This process requires a very high accuracy and a lot of patience, but once we're done with that, we can move on to replacing some of the insulation paper on the positive side of the cells and then take a look at my plan, which was 16S and 10P. However, things took a turn and you'll see next what is about to happen. First of all, a big thank you to everyone that helped me finish this pack. The battery is now ready, but it's much bigger than I planned. That happened due to a math error from my end, because I was never good at math. Long story short, I was missing a few cells. This is the reason the battery is bigger and colorful now. I got some cells from a friend and then some cells from another, and now this battery is a 16S 11P configuration. Besides the green cells and the LG ones, the pack contains now 10 Sony cells and lots of Samsung ones which are orange. The BMS has a discharge of 120 amps, which is not really necessary. I'm only going to use about 50 of them. At least for now. Got some anti-spark XT90 connectors for discharge and one XT30 for charging. Even though I have 3 charging ports on the scooter, I think I'm only going to use one 5 amps charger. And now comes the tricky part, where I have to wrap it up and check if it fits on the scooter. I did make some measurements, but you never know until you try it. For example, I thought I'd have enough space to wrap the pack in a shrink tube. That's not the case. I do have the shrink tub, but if I mount it, then I can't use the battery in my scooter. There's always a choice to be made, and now I'm choosing to finish this battery upgrade by all means necessary. Even though it looks like it fits, it doesn't. The pack is about 3 mm thicker than the space I have in the scooter, so I had to disassemble the whole thing again. In order to make the battery thinner, I had to organize every BMS wire and to replace the 2 thick positive wires with 4 thinner ones. After that, I had to cut 3 mm of each side of the Textolite case. My measurements were correct from the start, but I didn't notice that the lower side of the box had edges that would suspend the battery just enough to make it useless for my G-Booster. That's why I added some hard rubber strips under it, so that instead of being suspended only on the edges, the rubber strips will also support it from the middle.
Okay. Shoot! Ah, perfect. Perfect la linie. Gata.
After math, when I